Now I'd like to show you another very interesting microwave device, and that's a quarter wave transformer. We're going to take a look at how this is used in a typical microwave power splitter. A quarter wave transformer is a very simple device. It's used to match transmission lines that don't have the same impedance. So let's consider one transmission line which has a characteristic impedance of Z01 and another transmission line with a characteristic impedance of Z02. Perhaps we want to match a transmission line which has 50 ohms to another transmission line which has a characteristic impedance of 100 ohms. If we just butted them together, if we just connected them without anything in between, our reflection coefficient would be ZL minus Z0 over ZL plus Z0. ZL in this case would be Z02 and Z0 would be Z01. So unless those two were equal, the reflection coefficient would not be equal to zero, and that means that we would see a reflected signal right here at the end of the first transmission line. So to get rid of that reflection, we put a quarter wave transform in here. That's another transmission line which has a length of a quarter of a wavelength. That's why it's called a quarter wave transformer, and it has an impedance of ZQ. ZQ is equal to the square root of Z01 times Z02, and when we put that in there, the reflection coefficient ends up being zero, which is exactly what we want. Now here's a microstrip power splitter. It's a 3 dB power splitter, meaning that half of the power comes out on either side. Here's my input. Right there I'm putting all of my power in, and I'd like to have half of my power out on this side, and I'd like to have half out on this other side. Now we're using Microstrip, and notice here I've said this is a 50 ohm transmission line. That's my Z01. Here is my Z0 out. And here's my second Z0 out, and I want both of these those to be 50 ohms. But because they are 50 ohms here, if I had them simply in parallel, I'd have 50 in parallel with 50, which would not match right here, and I'd get a reflection there. So instead, right here at this junction, I want that to look like 50 ohms. So I'm going to put a transmission line that's 100 ohms in width, and 100 in parallel with 100 would be 50 ohms. Let's take a look at Microstrip. This is looking end-on. This is the line that you originally saw at the top. Here's the white plastic material, which is the sandwich, and here's the conducting underplate. For a microstrip, if we have a plastic with a dielectric constant of epsilon r, we can find something called the effective dielectric constant of the microstrip. What this is effectively is a volumetric average, considering that the fields come out something like this. It's sort of a volumetric average between the air up here, which has epsilon r of 1, and the plastic down here, which has a dielectric of epsilon r. When we sort of do a volumetric average, we end up with this equation, which is related to the height of the substrate and the width, w, of the transmission line, and that gives us some value of epsilon r that is less than the epsilon r of this substrate material. The wavelength of this transmission line is the wavelength in air divided by the square root of the effective dielectric constant, or that can be given by this equation that you see here. And the equation for the characteristic impedance of this transmission line is given right here. You'll learn more about this in microwave engineering, but suffice it to say that Z0 for a thin line is greater than Z0 for a thick line. So if this is the top of the transmission line that I see, and this is the wider transmission line, this is thin, and so this may have an impedance of 100 ohms, and this may have an impedance of 50 ohms.